this topic has been requested, and rightly so. A very essential part of human relationships is negotiations, both at the work front and the personal front. Smooth negotiations can create relaxed and productive days. And at the very heart of negotiations is the concept of win-win. A win-win situation means that any given situation finally works out in a manner that is mutually satisfying for both the parties involved. This brings in more ownership, and the chances of success are much higher since both parties feel equally benefited. Former Harvard Law School professor Roger Fisher, an academician, anthropologist, and negotiation expert William Ury, developed this approach in their book in 1981 called Getting to Yes. They've identified 5 clear-cut principles for negotiations. Let's take a quick look at these. 1, separate people from the problem. Keep aside all personal biases and make sure communication is clear and precise to avoid misunderstanding. Use active listening techniques, such as looking directly at the speaker rather than fidgeting on the phone, and allow everyone to finish before you start to talk. 2, focus on interests, not positions. People are seldom difficult just for the sake of it. Almost always, there are real and valid differences sitting behind conflicting positions. For example, consider that you're negotiating with your boss to get more resources for your team. You want more than 2 positions, and she may be in a position for reducing costs. Unless you find a common interest, such as increasing the team's productivity, the conflict situation will not resolve. 3, invent options for mutual gain. Let's go back to our example. Let's say you've identified increased productivity for mutual interest, but your company does not allow you to hire a new staff or to purchase a new equipment. You could see this as an opportunity to assess working practices, training opportunities, and inexpensive ways to increase efficiency. 4, use objective criteria. Try and agree on a framework for your discussions. These could be based on, for example, Calric score, which is a prescribed standard, or market comparatives, or the vision mission statement of the company, or a KQM standard. Going back to our first example, if both you and your boss have agreed on a budget regarding the resources of the team, and if you both proceed towards the same financial boundaries or limitations, there could be a win-win situation. 5, know your BATNA. BATNA stands for the best alternative to a negotiated agreement. Your BATNA is your fallback option in case you don't get everything you want. Let's return to our first example. If you start the negotiation with the bottom line for a demand of 2 extra departmental staff members, and your company refuses flatly, then the negotiations fall right there. However, if you started your request and your BATNA is to achieve a commitment to training and updated software, for instance, you're in a much better position and can get a much better result. Everyone stands to benefit in a win-win situation, since this is a cooperative and participatory approach. If there are any other specific topics that you would wish me to cover, please leave a comment below in the Shafism channel. Keep watching Shafism.